All right, President Trump helping out our next segment by ending his Twitter hiatus and tweeting pretty much exclusively about his disdain for the Russia investigation. His most recent tweet, just two words, but it says it all. Witch hunt. This comes as a new CNN poll shows that a majority of Americans do not believe President Trump takes the Russia investigation seriously enough. Let's bring in Carter Page. He's a former Trump campaign advisor who was the subject of FBI surveillance over his contacts with Russians. The House Intel Committee released dueling memos about the warrants to surveil him. Good to see you, Mr. Page.
Great to see you, Chris.
First question, and I say this to you every time I see you, but it's just usually off camera. You have had counsel at some point, right, when you were going to talk to the FBI?
On the witch hunt side, yes.
Does counsel ever say to you, stop going on TV and talking about this situation? You are creating a record for investigators.
I'm not concerned about a record, because the more the record comes out, as we've seen over recent weeks and months, the better. You know, now that we're starting to learn the truth, it couldn't get any better for me.
Well, we'll get into that. Have you been contacted by the special prosecutor, the special counsel?
You know, I don't talk about that because they've been quite very professional in terms of, you know, keeping confidentiality. And all I will say, Chris, is I've been interrogated over 30 hours in total, both by both executive branch and legislative branch of government.
But any of it by Mueller, you don't have to tell me the substance. You can respect them. But they have allowed people to come out and say, yeah, I talked to them, and here's what, you know, here's what it was. But have you talked to them at all? Will you answer that?
All I can say is, you know, someone leaked that I talked for 10 hours to the FBI last March.
Right.
Which is
that
now
was before
been,
yeah. Mueller. That's why I'm asking.
Exactly.
Well, do you have concerns that they're going to call you in and say, you said this, you said this, you said this. We checked it with this and this and this. No concerns.
I have no concerns. Everything, you know, listen, I'm trying to get out as much of the truth as I possibly can and that I can remember, right? So many of these questions, particularly if you've been in over 30 hours of testimony, right? I mean, if someone's really nitpicking, they'll try to say, well, there's a slight nuance between what you said at hour 12 and what you said at hour 27, right? I'm doing the best I can, you know, to the best of my recollection.
And you'll speak to anyone who wants to speak to you.
I have been, yeah, absolutely.
Well, that's true. That's quid pro demonstrato. Here you are in the chair once again.
Yeah.
You know, you look at a lot of this stuff and you say, this is just not believable. This is just so far-fetched. But let me ask you something about this. Isn't it equally far-fetched that if the FBI or whomever you want to put together as conspiracists wanted to get at Trump, here's what we're going to do. We're going to surveil this guy, Carter Page, who is not a fundamental aspect of Trump's campaign or his inner circle by any definition. True?
Yes.
Okay. Absolutely. We're going to surveil him, but we're going to do it through a FISA court. And it's going to get four different judges involved, but this is what we're going to do. We're going to do it just weeks before the election and then extend it well past the end of the election. And that's how we will hurt Trump. Doesn't that sound equally far-fetched as a caper?
Well, I think it's a cleanup act a little bit, right? They went down this path thinking that Mrs. Clinton was going to win. And so now they've got to, you know, find something, right? So the more
but Trump
keep it going
and his
as long
supporters
as possible.
Say they went after Carter Page as a way to hurt Trump. Why you? Why would they do that? Now we know there's so many other people they could have targeted with a lot more stuff to talk about that is close to the president than you. That doesn't seem to make sense, does it?
Because if they want to start this Russia collusions theory, what better way of doing that than having a photo of someone actually in Moscow in 2016? You know, I happened to give a speech.
They had tons more with Manafort.
But who?
And he was front and center in the campaign.
Was he ever in Russia in 2016?
I don't know. But I'm saying in terms of if you wanted to plant seeds, that's what I'm saying. You're just not the right target. I'm not saying I have no opinion plus or minus on what they have on you. I don't know.
Yeah.
But what I'm saying is you would not be the first place to start. Would you acknowledge that?
Well, I am I'm a private figure. I'm not someone that's, you know, I seem quite outspoken now. I'm hoping to go into the woods someday after this is all said and done. I'm just trying to get the truth out to make up for the terrible damage
right.
that was done for our
democracy. And again, I don't
democracy.
Well, but let's start in terms of damage for the democracy. You don't deny that Russians interfered in the election, do you?
All the evidence I've seen so far, Chris, indicates that there was much more interference by the U.S. government compared to the Russian government.
Wait. You think that the United States government interfered in this last election more than the Russians did?
If you look at the January 6, 2017 DNI report, mm-hmm. right, there are two themes. Number one, hacking. Mm-hmm. Number two, government propaganda, fake news.
Through right? troll farms and yeah. other types of social media seeding.
Well, actually, no, that report talks about the two main state-controlled assets.
But I'm saying the understandings...
RT and Sputnik.
But I'm saying right? the understandings from the intelligence community and what has come out to us through all the different investigations is that Russia had a concerted effort to try to mess with people's minds during this election and did it to some great effect. How it affected the election, we don't know. But it was certainly an earnest effort on their behalf. You say no?
Well, look, again, just look. Let's look at evidence we actually have. No one examined the DNC's server, right? You know, that was done outsourced to some, you know, law firm hired consultant to look at it instead of, you know, allowing the FBI to have a look. And now we understand why, I think. So that's on the hacking side.
Why, and, you know, shine a light on the unknown for purposes of speculation and ignore what is known?
Well, that's my point.
They know yeah. that Russian troll farms that were working with them were trying to disseminate negative information and seed different types of opposition here during the election to
mess with people's heads. Well, that's the second theme. I was talking about the hacking, and we know I've been hacked. I mean, that's as per
Understood,
the memo
but I'm
by
saying,
the minority.
Why deny that Russia was trying to mess with our election? Why do that?
Look, I have no evidence. I see the evidence that I, you know, if you compare everything that was written and said by RT and Sputnik and compare that to Radio Free Europe, 45 days before the election, give or take, and then 2 days before the election, putting out this fake story, world premiere of the dodgy dossier.
But all this stuff we'll get to the dossier, but all this stuff on social media that has been shown to be what we call now bots as part of our common vernacular. You know all of that is there. You know that the proof of it is fairly clear. Yeah. Why ignore it in favor of another political theory?
Well, because, again...
Because it makes you look like you're a little sympathetic to the cause. You know, that's why I'm pressing
I'm sympathetic to facts, Chris. And if you look, it was interesting that indictment a couple of weeks ago. Mm-hmm. They were talking about, you know, a couple million dollars here, right? Or maybe a couple... $1,000 in some swing states. Compare that to Radio Free Europe, sponsored by the federal agency Broadcasting Board of Governors. They had a budget of over $100 million. This is a big operation based in Washington.
But it's immaterial. It's immaterial to what we're talking about. I'm not saying what you like and don't like. They just indicted 13 different people. They could have done 55 or 60 if they wanted to, right, based on what they're looking at. Why ignore that? It just seems to... It puts you in a bad light.
Well, it's small potatoes.
Because you can't find a Republican who's involved with these investigations. Even Nunes, I bet you, if you asked him specifically, do you think the Russians interfered? Forget about the Trump campaign. Forget about any collusion. They all say yes. Yes, the proof is there. Was Trump or any of his people involved? Then you start getting different opinions, but not on whether or not the Russians were here.
You know, Chairman Nunes, that's a great example. Yes, you're absolutely right. We have totally different perspectives on things. But that's the beauty of democracy, Chris.
No.
You have different perspectives.
No. The beauty of democracy is the Mickeljohn marketplace of free ideas. I'm with you on that.
Yes.
Not on facts. You can have your own
absolutely.
Opinion. You can't have your own facts. The Russians tried to interfere in the election. That's a fact. That's a fact by everybody who looks at it objectively. To fight it raises suspicions of motivation.
Look, all I know is what I've personally experienced.
And, but that's not the basis for opinion. That you're too smart for that, Carter. The idea of what I know personally, that's not how we look at this. Now, I'll give you that on a second topic. I'll give you that on the memos and how they affect you and your situation potentially.
Yeah.
The dossier, what do you call it? The dodgy dossier?
Absolutely.
The dodgy dossier. They got it several weeks after they had already been looking into this situation. In the FISA application, you'll say it was just a footnote. But it was disclosed to the court where it came from. The president got it wrong, I think, where he said the FBI didn't disclose who the clients were. I think he was misreading recent information that Christopher Steele may not have been told who the clients were when he was doing his work for Axios. That's different. The president got it wrong, not unusual. But the court knew where it was coming from. It wasn't the only part of the application, and four different judges approved or extended it. What's wrong with that set of criteria in terms of surveilling somebody? What they found, what they didn't find, I don't know.
Chris, you know, district court judges, who sit on the FISA court, mm-hmm. it hasn't been fully revealed their their identities as of yet. But if you look at how busy their schedules are, they are just jammed with information. So to have them be stuck with trying to figure out something that's hidden in a footnote, and which, oh, by the way, in that long couple of line paragraph, it took them 5 footnotes to actually define what they're talking about. I mean, it's like reading hieroglyphics.
Except that works against your own point, right? Because one, if you want to hide something, you don't put it in. And two, if you are going to put it in, you put it in one footnote, not 5. You
know, sentence in the initial submission. And then for the Democrats to trying to explain what the heck they're talking about, it takes them 5 little footnotes to explain what this all means.
Give me a quick take on what you think the balance of information shows between the Nunes memo and the Schiff memo about your situation.
The beauty of it is, Chris, the more information comes out, the better. And it's excellent, the fact that there is a lot of pressure now to release the whole FISA application and all 4 of them. I mean, it's just so ridiculous. The more information we keep getting, the worse it seems. So, you know, I think both of them are very supportive in a lot of ways.
And just once again, for the record, you never met with for purposes of collusion, tried to steer the Trump campaign towards sympathetic efforts with the Russian government, or tried to negotiate on behalf of any Russian agents anything to help Russian politics, like with sanctions, in other words, with the Trump administration.
Not only is that true, Chris, when I spent a couple days in Moscow in July 2016, I was trying to do everything possible to stay as low profile and not start any waves, so that there's no kind of questions or potential. You know, I knew people, you know, it seemed like there might be some possibility that someone would try to pin something on me, right?
So
I've spoken at universities in Moscow going back 15 plus years.
Right? But if you thought if you thought people were going to find it suspicious, if you thought the Russians may try to work you, why put yourself in the situation?
No one in Russia has ever tried to work me.
Government sources say that in their investigating, that the Russians did see you as a target of opportunity.
They say that, and I think they said a lot of things on January 6, 2017, and that they got wrong as well. So.
Carter Page, you are always welcome to come here and be tested and make your case to the American people. Thank you for taking the opportunity.
Thanks a lot, Chris.